Yes, in the last class, so I had some, we had some, we encountered some problem regarding the sign convention. No, not sign convention, it was the problem with this part over here. This is essentially right. So what I was, I mean, our problem was it should be V naught minus V naught, V minus V, right? And then it will be please mute yourself. Okay, so we can take this expression minus dq minus dw is equal to du. Okay, and this dw not only incorporates this dw boundary work plus this as well. So essentially, I can write dq minus of delta boundary work plus the surrounding against the surrounding dv, and then we can write du. And yes, and then we can write q, if minus signs I take over right side, dq plus dw plus pdv is equal to minus du. Okay, or if I want these two only, then I can move this thing here, then I can write minus du minus p naught dv. So this is the expression I should write. So minus dv is minus du is there, and this would be minus of pq. Okay, and then if you integrate and if you take up properly, so this is v naught minus this, and now it will be switched. And now if I take the plus sign over here, then it will be switched, and then things are in right fashion. So basically this slight algebra we have missed actually. Okay, so before moving into, and we have come across the exergy change. In closed systems. Okay, we have seen this. Today we will talk about exergy change of open systems, but before we will take up that particular example we left behind. So this was this question I want to take up today. A 50 kg iron block shown in figure, this figure, initially at 200 degree C and is allowed to cool at 27 degree C. Okay, so from 200 to 27 degree C, it is allowed to cool by transferring the heat to the surrounding at 27 degree C. Okay, so your T naught is also given, and your T is, initial T is this. Determine the reversible work and the irreversibility for this process. So reversible work means, so it doesn't mention anything about reversible heat engine right now. So essentially you have iron block and it is cooling from 200 degree C to 27 degree C, and we need to know what is the reversible work that we can get out of it, the amount of Q it releases. Okay, through this Q, how much reversible work I could get, and essentially the exergy. Okay, so again, so methodology is same. So whatever this Q is liberating to the environment, we can connect this Q to some sort of heat engine, some cyclic heat engine, and we could expect some work out of it, and it is leaving the some amount of heat to the surrounding temperature, that is 27 degree C. So this is how your general structure of your problem would look like. Okay, now my question is how to calculate this W, since at every instant your temperature is decreasing. Okay, so temperature would go from 200 to 198 to 195 or so, and this Q would also be changing. So this Q is essentially dQ in some sense. It will be differential change in temperature would give you differential change in, or differential amount of heat that is coming out of the system. Understood? So this relation, you can understand, this differential change in temperature will give you differential change, the heat of that is coming out in differential form. Okay. And then this dq will be given to this reversible heat engine, and it will give me some dw reversible in some form. Okay, so we can write the expression dw reversible as if is in the differential form. So we can, so what was the formula we were looking? W reversible minus T lower by T times Q in. In differential form we can write, let's suppose I am not writing currently this, currently differential, so I can write in terms of T lower will be the atmospheric temperature, T naught, right? So T naught by T, and this T is my variable, this T is my variable, and this T is belongs to the particular temperature this iron block contains, times dq, you can say. So this is the differential form of formula we can write. This is a similar thing I wrote in differential form. Okay, now to calculate the net or the total reversible, we can actually integrate both side. Okay, so integrating both side, this will give me the net, the reversible total, final minus initial, 1 to 2 I am going, 1 to 2 I am going. So basically 1 is where? 1 is the instant you are at right now, and you are going till dead state, that is T naught, right? And this is obviously this from 1 to 2 or T to T naught, so it will give me the net total which is required. And this is nothing but from T to T naught, 1 minus T naught by T times dq. So this is the expression you could expect from this step. Okay, now dq, how to calculate the dq amount of heat? We have already seen in our specific heat chapter. So the amount of, so dq again I can write m c dt for any solid. So this much amount of heat, I mean, remember what is my c, or mass times specific heat times change in temperature would give me change in heat. Or so to say, what is this C stands for? dq by dt in some sense. So essentially for unit change in temperature, how much heat, the quantity of heat, how much heat it gains or it loses for unit amount of change in the temperature, that is what specific heat was, or of any solid. So this is how it is defined. If total mass is m, mass will be multiplied, so this is per unit mass, so mass would be multiplied, so net amount of heat is this much. So we can plug in this expression over here, and w reversible total, these kind of questions you may expect in your engineering services examinations. So it's kind of tricky and lots of integrations. Maybe gate also they may ask, but gate I would expect smaller questions. So T naught, 1 minus T naught by T, and this dq is m c dt. Also one more thing, so since heat is coming out of the system, okay, so minus sign would be here. So this formula is based on the how much heat is it is taking up. Okay, so if your solid is taking giving heat outside to the to its body, the minus sign would be here. This is the sign convention we would follow. So minus sign would be here, and we can now integrate in this fashion minus mc dt and minus of minus plus t0 here over t0, and this would be t0 is constant, t0 will be outside. Sorry, let me write it again. So t0 mc would be outside, t0 and this would be dt by t. Okay, so this would be mc t minus t0 plus t0 mc, and this expression would give me ln t0 by t, isn't it? So this ln t0 by t. Any doubt writing this as this? Anybody, you can ask. And this would give me, yes, this would give me, so C specific heat of iron you can check from table, or it would be given
T average is
0.45, C of iron rod is 0.45
kilojoule per kg Kelvin.
It's given. You can plug all these things here, you will get 8191 kilojoules. So this is your work reversible total. So we didn't apply the straightforward formula here, because my TH is changing at all moments of time, right? At every moment TH is changing and Q is also changing. That is why we have taken up this differential form, and then we are integrated from first state to initial to final state, which is your dead state. So this is how you should tackle these kind of problems, and this is also the exergy of the iron block. So this is the total available energy in the block. Okay, now the question is, what is the irreversibility of this process? So in reality, this iron rod, so this is only my system, right? This is only my system. So in question, it is not given that reversible heat engine is there. Okay, it's not there, it's hypothetical. So since this is hypothetical, so no work is right now, it is producing no work. Useful work. So my irreversibility can be written here, work reversible minus work useful or actual. So actual is 0, and this one is 8190 minus 0 is equal to 8190. So all the heat that is being coming out of the system or out of the iron rod, iron block, is totally your irreversible energy, or the exergy destroyed. So the available energy is being destroyed in the form of heat, because you are not taking, in reality you are not taking any work. Okay, I mean in this example. Okay, since my system is only iron block. So any doubt?
Yeah, this is crucial.
No doubt. Okay, somebody tell me yes or no.
No, sir.
Okay. So we will move ahead in today's lecture, the exergy change of open system. So let me write the exergy change of the closed system, and the only thing that an open system will incorporate is the flow work or flow exergy. So flow work, so since we for open system we encounter with flow work, and the work is a high grade energy which can totally be converted to the useful work. So whatever the flow work we have will be equal to the flow exergy of the system, and this will be added to the closed system. So let's suppose phi closed system, and we call this as phi open system. So phi open system, exergy of open system is nothing but in general way, in generic sense, exergy of closed system plus the flow exergy. Okay, and this phi closed, let me write the phi closed first. We have already done this, so this is over here. You can write so this one, I can write this one exactly. So phi of closed system is nothing but u minus u naught plus p naught v minus v naught minus t naught small s minus small s naught plus v square by 2 plus zz. So this was my closed system exergy. Now I am going to add with the x flow, whatever the flow work that is being done by your fluid packet. So we have already seen that we can actually think of flow work as a imaginary piston work that is happening by this packet of fluid to move inside any system. So since you are doing work to move inside this particular enclosure, and you may be coming out from here, so fluid flowing will have, let's suppose this is my pressure P, is specific volume V, and it is working against P naught and V. So essentially the flow work is the net flow work minus the work against the surrounding. Okay, so this is the net flow work for not flow work, I'm really sorry, this is the flow exergy, net flow exergy by this fluid packet would be written as P minus P naught by V, since this is working against surround. So everything we are going to take up things in reference to environment or surrounding. So that is why this P naught additional term comes into picture in negation. Okay, so this P minus P naught times P. So this is the thing we are going to plug in over here, and we can actually write U minus U naught plus P naught V minus V naught. Sorry, this is minus T naught S minus S naught plus V square by 2 plus ZZ plus P minus P naught times V. Now we can, what we will do, we will take up these two things here. So this is P naught V minus V naught plus P minus P naught times V. So can we do some algebra over here? P naught V minus P naught V naught plus PV minus P naught V. So right, so P naught V and P naught V cancels, and it is left with these two expressions. So this PV I will write in front of U, and this P naught V naught I will write in front of U naught. So U plus PV minus U naught plus P naught V naught. Okay, and rest of the expressions I will write T naught S minus S naught plus v square by 2 plus gz. Okay, and these two are already taken care. Now this term is what? Your h. What is this term? H naught. Dead state enthalpy and enthalpy of the system right now. So h minus h naught, I can write minus t naught s minus s naught plus v square by 2 plus gz, which is written over here. So flow exergy in our sense of open system. Exergy of the open system can be written in this fashion, which is already written over here. I make things messy, right? I try to not to in future. So this is, so again, this is intuitive also, since we are doing some boundary work. So enthalpy may come into picture here, as we have seen in our open system energy analysis as well. Yes. Now, similar to the previous change in exergy of open system can be written phi 2 minus phi 1 can be written in terms of this. This is straightforward. We'll take up this example after coming back to once we learn this. Okay. Now the next topic, similar to the what we have learned in entropy transfers and energy transfer, this exergy also is being associated with, I mean the exergy transfer from a system or to the system can be done, and or is it it is associated with heat, work and mass both. Unlike entropy, it is being transferred through heat and mass only, where energy and exergy both are associated with heat, work and mass, and we'll see how. Exergy by heat transfer. So again, we can think of any system with temperature at a temperature T, and it is giving away Q heat to T naught. So the useful so since there is a heat transfer that is occurring, and through this heat transfer, we already seen this several times in this particular chapter, that this heat transfer is associated with exergy transfer from this system to somewhere outside of the system. And this formula we have again I'm writing, this is eta reversible. We can make use of reversible heat engine. We can take some work out of it, and then some surrounding, and then we can write, if this is eta reversible, it's working on under the efficiency of this heat engine is eta reversible times Q, this being whatever the heat that is being transferred, and this eta reversible is again I can write in terms of lower by higher times Q. So this is well known, nothing new, we have already seen so many times in this chapter. So this is how it is, the exergy transfer by heat can be written in this form. If it would be a differential form, so differential exergy can again be written 1 minus T naught by T dQ, and if it is if want to integrate it both side from any state 1 to state 2, so the total exergy can be written in terms of in this form as well. So exergy transfer by work, so this is straightforward, exergy transfer by work. So work, if there is no boundary work that is happening, So there is no piston that is being pushed against environment if there are other forms of works. So all the exergy will be treated as it's available. All the work that is being done by the system is basically the available energy in the system and can be written as exergy of the system. But if it is pushing against surrounding, some boundary work is happening, we have to negate that surrounding work, and then the overall available work is been written in this form. Okay, so nothing new. We can think of all these things, heat transfer, entropy transfer, and exergy transfer in this manner as well. Let's suppose I have a wall whose left temperature is T1 and right temperature is T2, and T1 is higher than T2. So the heat transfer that is occurring, that would occur in this fashion, and this heat transfer is governed by Fourier's law, which we will take up in heat transfer course. So Q is basically is proportional to K dt by dx, some sort of this sort of equation may come across. Okay, so this is this Q will be same from left to the wall and from wall to outside. So this Q would be same, the quantity would be same. Okay, there won't be any discontinuity there. No, if it is ideally it is happening heat transfer. And the heat transfer, entropy transfer associated with this Q, since this Q and this temperature of this wall is T1, so entropy associated with this heat is Q by T. We have already seen Q by T1, and since this is lower temperature, this is T2 is lower than T1, and Q is same. This Q and Q is same, so Q by T2. So Q by T2. Would be larger than Q by T1. How? Since this T2 is lesser, since this is lesser and this is higher. Okay, so lesser the thing in the denominator, the overall value would be higher. So you can see that entropy is being, this much amount of entropy is being generated. In this particular thing, so this much entropy has been generated essentially. So any heat transfer process encounters or associate with entropy generation, and exergy transfer is kind of opposite, where exergy transfer is the thing is, this is inevitable. Exergy is being destroyed, it means available energy being destroyed. Okay, and the exergy associated with Q and T1, we have already seen that 1 minus T, so T is T1 divided by the outside heat is T0, both the side, dead state is T0 times Q. So this is the expression over here. And this one right hand side, you will have 1 minus, so I have done wrong, I'm really sorry. So this is lower by T1 is higher. Let's suppose dead state is at lower temperature, and this is T0 by T2 times Q. So this would be, so this thing would be greater than 1 minus T0 by T2 times Q. Why? Because T1 is higher. So this, since this is higher, so 1 minus is, so 1 minus I'm subtracting something from it, and 1 minus, I'm subtracting something from it. And since T1 is higher, so I'm subtracting higher from here. Right? And I'm subtracting lower from here. Okay. So this, after subtracting, you will get higher thing. Isn't it? And this is lower. Okay. So in sense, your exergy is being destroyed in the form of this minus this. This minus this is equal to exergy destroyed. Okay, in some pictorial sense, we have already, we can see over here. The third thing is exergy transfer by mass. So exergy again can be thought of as a extensive, some extensive property as well. More the mass you have in your hand, more the exergy it will have. Okay, so this is straightforward. Exergy transferred by mass would be mass times the this phi is the open system exergy, and which is that the big expression, and times the mass. So yes, this is again straightforward. Okay, I want to take up one.
Hey, Dhruvi.
So any problem? So 32. Okay, we have 8 minutes or more. 10-13 minutes. Okay, today I also want to talk about the decrease in exergy. So this example tells me that there is always, any heat transfer process always accompanies exergy destruction. Okay, so available energy being destroyed, or in some sense entropy being generated. So these are opposite. So we'll look into the decrease of exergy principle today. Okay, and which would be advantageous to work with this energy balance equation, since we need to look for total exergy destroyed. So this we would look from here. So from energy balance, we can in any system. So let's suppose I have a system. Let's suppose I have a closed system, and no in, E in is zero, and E out is also zero. So the change in energy of the system is again would be zero. Okay, since this is a closed system, no mass is coming out, let's suppose. So this expression I can write at state 1 to 2, the difference is zero. Similarly, for entropy balance, we have already seen S in minus S out plus S gen, this is the additional term, is equal to the change in entropy of the system. So since this is a closed system, so S gen can be written as, so no entropy and entropy is coming out and into the system currently, let's suppose. So S gen can be written as S2 minus S1. Okay, now we can multiply this by T naught, let's suppose dead state temperature, and we can subtract this thing from this to this, this minus minus plus. So we can write, so this is T naught S gen is equal to T naught S2 minus S1 minus or plus E1 minus E2. I can write that. Okay. And from this expression, this expression I can I write this thing? Okay. Yes, so we can rearrange in this fashion. So minus, let's suppose minus I am taking out, T naught S gen is equal to T naught or minus T naught S2 minus S1 minus I am multiplying both side, and this is plus E2 minus E1. Yes, this is the better form. Okay, and we have already seen this thing, E phi 2 minus phi 1 change in exergy of the system. Okay, and okay, not only closed, we are talking also about closed and no heat is also, interaction is also happening here. So this is closed, so essentially I can write isolated system. Okay, so for isolated system I can so this phi 2 minus phi 1 is written, let me come again, this formula E2 minus E1 P0 V2 minus V1 and this one, right? This is E2 minus E1 plus P0 V2 minus V1 and minus T0 S2 minus S1. Okay, and since there is no change in the volume of the system because this is closed system, this goes away, and so this is for isolated system. So this plus this minus this is essentially this one. So I think I written mass basis, so without mass basis I can write this one as my phi 2 minus phi 1. Okay, since this is mass basis, so I should not write phi, I should write x, not mass basis, things are x. So x2 minus x1 is it nothing but T naught S gen. We arrive that, right? So right hand side you can see the same expression is there. So we can see over here that the change in exergy of isolated system is equal to minus T naught S gen. And T naught is a positive quantity. Why? Since this is absolute, so no negative values are possible for T naught. Okay, since this is absolute, and S gen will also be positive, or in some sense, if reversibility is there, zero, it should be zero. So we can essentially write that change in exergy of isolated system, even if you are doing nothing, is, and since this is negative sign over here, so these quantities are positive, so overall it is negative. This is less than zero or equal to zero for reversible. So no matter what you do, even if you are sitting ideally in a closed system, I mean closed and isolated system, your exergy is being destroyed, right? This is the beauty of mathematics. You can arrive at things quickly. Okay, see, so no matter what you do, your exergy is being x2 minus x1 will be less than zero. It means x2 will be always less than x1 no matter what you do. So the available energy of final state would always be lesser than initial state, no matter what process you are doing. Even if you are doing nothing, things will, availability will be going towards zero or dead state. Okay, so we'll take this thing tomorrow, and so few examples, the exergy balance of closed system and open system. similar what we have done in our energy and entropy. Okay, and now we have total exergy destroyed expression we have in hand, we can actually do something over here. Okay, with this we'll see how we can go forward, and this is for open systems. We'll take up these things, and yes, any doubts so far? And tomorrow we will finish this chapter, and we are done with probably second or mid same sort of syllabus would be ending with. So any doubt so far?
No, sir.
Okay. So I didn't get time to write those PDF solutions, sir. I mean, maybe I would do in this, but this weekend. Okay. Let me take the attendance. So we have 3 minutes left. So what should we do?